a few years' time, if we lose and if we start not to care and if we start to give bad shows, I just hope people don't come. That's what I'd like to see. I just hope two guys, you know, will come into a restaurant, sit down and talk to you and tell you that they think you two are just the worst band in the world, if that's what we're doing. But I'm telling you, I don't believe that will happen.
Things should change. If you don't change, your music doesn't change. It becomes stagnant and stale. And so I hope things change me. I just hope that I never walk on stage, and I'm sure it's the same for Larry, that the four of us never walk on stage and go through the motions. You know, just plug in and say, okay, lads, tonight, you know, another night, let's take the money and run. Because that's bullshit, and that's why we're here.
We take our music seriously, but really, I don't think we take ourselves that seriously. We're a rock and roll band.
It's the work that's important, and, you know, in the end, the rest is really unimportant. And we have an amazing audience. They're very elastic. And we have stretched them and pushed them, and they followed us out on a ledge. And I think we've been very lucky. I think, you know, not many bands would get away with this. And we're in this position that, you know, people play what we write on the radio and come to see us play. So we're in this position. I think it's our duty to abuse it.
Rock and roll the disrespect it deserves.
Exactly.
Amen.
The heart is a blue, shoots up through the stony ground, but there's no room, no space to rent in this town.
There's a sort of obvious contour in the life and the career of a band like you two, where you get to a certain place and you start to live off your past. We've seen this in groups in the past, you know, gone by. And groups that we grew up, you know, blew my mind in the 70s, and then you just see them just turn into turgid, awful rock dinosaurs. And so the fear that that might happen to us has kept us going and determined to prove ourselves and determined to make our best work now. It's a beautiful day.
Record with you two is a really messy, messy situation, because you got four people who, you know, just feel very strongly about what they do, but I think the thing that separates perhaps you two from other groups that I've met is that we have a giant ego, but it's one that we share rather than four individual egos. Do you know what I mean?
Trying to make the perfect record, and that's why we keep making them, is because we never feel like we've done it. So that's still the goal for us, is the work.
And the Grammy goes to
you two,
beautiful day.
It's a beautiful day, you two.
Back to where you started sometimes to remember why you did this. For us, you know, making this album was either going to be our last album or the beginning of something.
What are we on?
It's like Lassie's gone home. That's our thing. You know, you won't get two crap albums in a row from us. And because we'll be the first to put the bullet in the head of the band, because, you know, we've just a lot of. You know, it's about self-respect at a certain point.
I guess it's the ideal kind of career arc, is that, you know, you keep making records and you keep getting better at it, and you get a younger audience every time, and this record certainly seems to have done that. It's a real surprise, but it's something that we always felt was what we should be able to do. You know, it would be a little bit difficult to go into the studio every time thinking that, you know, people didn't really want to hear what we were doing.
And if the darkness is to keep us apart,
we have to make it interesting for ourselves. And, you know, we challenged our audience and we definitely took them up mountains and down ravines and stuff like that. And, you know, that's what you got to do. And you got to do those things to get to make the record that we've just made. And we're not embarrassed about that. And we've got a license with our audience. And that's why our audience is so important. We've got a license to do those things. And we've never repeated ourselves, and people think that that's some sort of technique. The reality is that we wouldn't know how to. You know, we're actually not qualified to do that. But I think that, you know, we want to do other things. And, you know, talking to Age earlier on about, you know, is this the pinnacle? Is this where it's at? And it's like there's unfinished business for you two. There are still things left for us to do. And who knows when we'll do that, and making great records and having great songs out there and getting on the radio and challenging all the other stuff that's out there. That's our job.
We're gonna play on TV, we're gonna do interviews, we're gonna make records until we can't actually come up with something interesting until we stop, or when we stop challenging our audience and challenging ourselves, then we'll stop. We're not ready to stop. And we will make that decision when the time comes. We don't want anyone else to make that decision for us.
Part of this band and able to make the records that we make and able to do the shows that we do, that kind of does most of it for me. There's not much else left over after those things are done.
There's a great sense of the future, I feel, at the moment. Really, you know, not that interested in the past. Feels like starting again or something. And there's all the joy that goes with that, you know, the beginning of a new century. And I think just, you know, for us, just rediscovering, you know, why we wanted to be in a band, you know.
Do you ever worry about maybe becoming too popular?
No, that's not a worry for me, I must admit.
It's a tough life being a pop star, you know, and at the end of the day, when you've paid all the bills and put the kids through college and that, you know, there's only enough left for a small island off the South Pacific. So I mean, it is tough.
We're just you two, you know. You know, everyone is saying we're so important and that, but we're just important to ourselves and to our audience.
Aren't you ever worried that all that success might spoil you?
I hope it does.
Has it spoiled yet?
Spoiled us rotten.